This is a rather interesting setup. Trying to adjust it on the go here. Not very good with hand-eye coordination. I actually have to take this off, push this a little further back because right now the GoPro is angled slightly upwards, like kind of like that. I won't be getting anything on ground level. I have to pause the video. I think I figured out what the problem was. It'll just have to be sideways like that. My fingers are not strong enough, unfortunately, to screw the screw back on. From this, I can pretty much say that the GoPro is indeed heavier than the action cam. Did this with the action cam yesterday, and it was not shaking like this. And right now I can feel the camera is shaking like that. What I'm gonna have to do is stick it back up right here. It's just too heavy. I'll be right back. Unfortunately, this is the only way for me to actually get video footage with the GoPro so far, because I've tried toying with it every single way possible. Well, I think possible. And this is basically how the camera has to be. Unscrew this just a little bit. I feel like I have to angle the camera a little bit higher.
No, exactly how wide 100, I think 80 degree field of view is. This is the best I can do, which tells me that I learned something. If I wanted to get a perspective of a lower angle when I'm driving, I have to use the action cam instead, because then that way I can mount it on the side of my ear, make it look more interactive in a sense, compared to like GoPro right now, which is mounted on my forehead. And there's three people walking behind me. I don't think they're gonna move onto the sidewalk. So I guess that was an interesting thing that I noticed. So I guess I do really have to bring two cameras. I only have one head strap mount. So it's either capturing a lower, seeing the odometer and the steering wheel, or seeing the road ahead of me. I also brought this thing with me. The parent actually wants pictures of squirrels. Got a video about a week ago with the phone. I know I uploaded it onto YouTube as well, and I took a screenshot of it in Premiere Pro. People had no idea where she took it at, which I thought was hilarious. Just in case, you know, brought the camera back out. I brought my 85mm. Switched over from the A6000 to the A7 II because it's not as if I'm getting any motion shots. And it's not as if I need the crop factor anyways. It's a nice day today. See, that's what I love about summer in California. Summer in Asia, too humid. 70% humidity plus like 80 degree weather basically equals 90 degrees. On days like this, high 70s, low 80s, no clouds, light breeze. That's pretty. That's what I like about mounting a camera on my forehead, is that I don't have to literally like moving my phone up and wherever. You know, if a camera is strapped to my head, all I have to do is turn and aim. Gonna switch over to the action cam because I did bring the action cam with me. Switch over to the side POV.
This looks absolutely pathetic, but it works surprisingly. And I'm hoping that I don't have the camera aimed. Actually, let me see. Okay, so I have the camera aimed a little too far to the right. Gotta twist this back around. Thanks to the steady shot, the camera does look to be a little... Okay, well, I guess that's fine. We modified this a tad bit. This is basically as ridiculous as it will get. Wait, I don't even know if I can wear my mask now. Modify it as we go. It's proving to be difficult trying to put my mask on. Got the left side on easily. There we go. It's perfect. Slight adjustment, turning it to the right a tad bit. I will work with that. Hi. You too, thank you. Just got my drink, and later on actually I might head over to Las Gatas Luxury. I think what they call themselves is now the Luxury Collection. They got a really special Aston Martin. All I know is it doesn't have a... The top half is non-existent, basically. Let's see how this s'mores frap tastes once I take the mask off. If I really do go to Las Gatas Luxury, I think what I'm gonna do is gonna try to make the video not as long as the other ones. I won't be doing any time lapses because it just makes no sense at all. Parent wants me to stop by Cupertino again today to pick up some more groceries from another store. Afterwards, Might actually go to Meat Fresh. Gonna try to squeeze in some time, head over to the dealership, see that car. The most efficient way, honestly, might be hopping onto 85, going all the way down to Cupertino. Maybe exiting onto Wolf or something. I kind of want to get another perspective on how quickly the RX can take that on-ramp onto 85 from 280. Yesterday, I took the Miata actually into Cupertino to do a sound test with the Sony Actioncam, which I finally was able to connect the Sony Actioncam to my iPhone. For some reason, when I first tested it out, since I don't have a QR code for the AS100V, it came out way before QR codes were in existence. I tried connecting the SSID once, first time it failed, and then I did it again, and then it went through. Imaging Edge Mobile is for both photos and videos. I'm gonna be screwed over for one with the Sony. I want to use the GoPro, however, again, problem is, I can't hook the GoPro onto the side of my head because it's too heavy. This just shows me how much lighter the action cam is compared to the GoPro. Hopefully I come across some squirrels. Parent wants more pictures of them. I'm holding the action cam for now. No kidding. Out of all 20 minutes I was out here, I didn't see any squirrel. And then there he is. There's a squirrel actually right there where the leaves were just moving. I can see him. He's right there behind that stack of tree leaves. I'm gonna stick some images in right now. It's right there. Unfortunately, I didn't bring my A6000, otherwise I would zoom in. It's really cool. Gotta get out of here real quick. Still gotta do some grocery shopping. Look at this thing. I mean, this is crazy. If I'm walking too fast, I'll just slow down the footage in Premiere Pro. But look at this. This is insane. Here's what the inside looks like. Let's come over to the other side. And I love the details, how they put the do not step, and then the FA18. Me and the Ted, actually, one of the salespersons here, and also one of the nicest people ever, we both agreed that this is a rare gem, because not only is it a V12, this also is not Aston Martin style. I know it's Ferrari's because of the SP1 and SP2, but for Aston Martin to come out with a similar style, well, basically identical, but similar, and road legal, like, this is absolute crazy. Compared to, you know, I wonder how many people would actually take this over this in the background, because that's the regular version, right? I wonder how many people would actually get this. Me personally, if money were no issue, I would pick this over the other one. Like, this one's just, with the exception of no windshield, because I don't want to be driving and with bugs flying into my face. But this is essentially like the rebel car, if you would, because it definitely stands out. Definitely much, much, much different. Like 100% different from all the other, you know, sports cars out there, even the ones that they sell here. Definitely one of a kind. You know, I wonder, looking at the brake spots. Sorry, am I in your way?
No!
Looking at the brake size, it won't even fit in the Miata. I've joked with my friends. Sorry?
It looks like a what? 20-inch from 19, 18-inch?
I...
17? This?
Maybe 20.
Yeah, it looks like a 20.
I've joked about putting Ferrari brake pads and rotors on my Miata, and my friends told me, no, you would break an axle doing that. Just a quick overview. I did get permission to film video because this is actually public now on Instagram. They posted it, I think, 1 or 2 days ago. I hit up Ted and asked if I could come in and get a few shots. So, also asked him if I could get video. No worries, you're good. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Just came out of the store. Didn't want to film in there. I felt like I would be a nuisance in there. With Asian stores though, especially with this one, they keep self-awareness at a very high level. Less time I spent in them, the better. This is basically what I got. I don't know what we want this for, but got this, you know, family and I can share it. Never had it before. So that's pretty much when you boil it in water, it turns into, I guess you would call it watermelon tea in a sense. And that adding with grass jelly is really good. I got myself this because I'm really thirsty right now. Might grab some meat fresh later, I don't know yet. Just in case if we don't, that's why I got this. I want something sweet right now. It's really hot still. I don't know how it is, maybe it's like low 80s. No, going over to Joanne's, see if they have craft fur. And that should be the end of the vlog. Let's head on over. I just got here and unfortunately they're doing deep cleaning until next month. I'm hoping no one got COVID. That sucks because I kind of rushed here hoping to get some craft fur. No can do. So I guess in that case, I'm gonna do a time lapse or something. Maybe, I don't know. We'll see. Full battery right now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep it running. See what happens. I'm approaching this turn at, nah, I can't, probably 30 miles per hour. I'm at 30 right now. So I could push 35, but right now, I'm at 35 miles per hour. So I guess tires give out at 40. Like that's not gonna happen. All right, we're going down to 50, 45, 40, and slower because this guy does not know how to turn. We got about this meter here.